I am here today to explain more about the female goddess power. This is what we call it today. We used to call it the creation and birth. What you call the male energies today was called the visionary creative energy. The creative energy was used to envision and the creation energy was used to birth the envisioned creation. We will use the names female goddess power and male god visionary energies for now. In the beginning there was balance between these two energies as you all know, simply because we have no duality in spirit. Everything and everyone works together for the greater good of all that is. We didn't even have a need at that time to name them, this all came later. The earth has been going through many changes, but the one that is happening right now is as new for us as it is for you and everyone else in the universe. Yes, many planets are more advanced than the planet Earth at this time, but planet Earth has been a special planet and the most difficult one to incarnate on, because of this duality consciousness and the almost complete removal of the spiritual connections to the higher dimensions. This experience that you are undergoing right now, which includes bringing back the balance between the female and male energies, has never been done before, and hopefully we will never have to do this again. We are all just like you, full of expectation of what is going to happen, and we see the progress that has been made. When it was finally time to return the female goddess power energies to our beloved planet, we celebrated and were overwhelmed with love for all of you that made this possible. The planet has been in mostly male energies for several thousands of years, and this is the next step for the planet itself as well. She has been holding her ground, and now she is finally allowed to purge herself from all that was being held inside of her and around her. The dark negative energies that were attached to this duality thinking and acting. So all we ask from you now is to fully accept and embrace these female power goddess energies and integrate them into your physical and spiritual life. We have noticed the change of the energies around you because of this. Do not let it stop you from integrating these energies inside yourself. Don't let yourself be carried away by the effects of it. And I am not only speaking to the women, but the men are involved in this process as well. Women are still acting from an abused, misunderstood point of view. Men are acting from a being scared of the power of women point of view. Yes, there might be some beyond this, but from what I have seen, there is still a lot to learn for all of you men and women alike. Now I would like to tell you a story that might explain a little bit of what has happening from the beginning of the creation of planet Earth. At one point in time there was a group of 12 men and 12 women. Or to be correct, there were 12 souls using the visionary creative energy and the other 12 were using the creation and birth energy. To keep it simple, we will use the description of male, men and female, woman for this story. These 24 souls were the first council under God. The men were the creators and bringing visions into reality. The women were using their energies to birth the creation. At one point they decided to lend their power to the men so they could work in an easier way. Both energies were still in balance at that time. In this way the planet Earth was created, and many souls were starting to use this planet to learn and experience more of themselves. The Council of 24 was there to guide and create learning experiences. The incarnated souls were staring to ask for a more physical experience, which seemed logical following the spiritual experience. At that time the earth was already inhabited by physical animals. And since every soul has a curiosity to learn and experience more and more, they wanted to know what it would be like to have a physical body, just like the animals. Most of the animals you have right now are descendants of the animal that were there at that time. So the experiment with the physical body began on planet Earth. At first all the souls were androgynous, but after seeing the animals being dived in male and female and seeing the structures within these groups and how they reproduced themselves, it was thought that this would be another great learning experience. So it was decided to make the female and male incarnations possible on the planet Earth. The Council of 24 was still there to guide and oversee all this. At first in Lemuria all was still balanced, people were balanced even though they were incarnating as male and female in the physical, their energies were balanced in male and female. They still had their completely open connection to the higher dimensions. There were no power struggles as was seen with the animals where they would have the need for a leader. They were just living a life in the physical. They started to experiment with different types of food, how to make music in the physical and much more. More and more different circumstances were created, like weather changes and earth changes. Everything was a learning experience for these souls. There was no death at that time. When people wanted to leave, they would disintegrate their body and move to the higher dimensions until they wanted to go back, and they would choose a mother and father, and these souls together would decide what learning experiences they wanted to have. This was all happening in perfect balance and complete connection to the higher dimensions. At one point, the male part of the council decided to create more extreme learning experiences. Everything that was introduced so far was not interfering with the balance, so they thought it was time to start introducing something new. Some of these were resulting in diseases, imbalance between the male and female. One reason for this was that more and more souls were starting to focus on just the physical experience, while others were still just there to integrate these experiences in the spiritual. Every soul had a free will and could make their own choices in what to experience and learn. But this did result in jealousy and anger, because the souls that were concentrating more on the physical were starting to lose some of their connection with the higher dimensions, and with the diseases coming into their physical bodies, they needed help from souls that were still connected fully. These souls were able to heal these diseases and help them get their connection back. The male part of the group was exited and introduced more experiences to these souls. This resulted in people being more balanced, advanced than others, and this was bringing in more anger and jealousy among the souls that had incarnated. The women were starting to go against the learning experiences that were created, because they were seeing an imbalance between the males and females, which they thought was not supposed to happen. But the men were not stopping, and they were starting to be influenced by a feeling of power when seeing how what they created was influencing the life of these souls on the planet. And since they were using the power of the woman together with their own, they were staring to see themselves as being the visionary that was birthing the creation. After several council meetings, the women decided to take back their power that was assisting the men. So the men were without the power of actually bringing their visions into creation. The men started looking for different ways to make this possible. One of them was guiding the men and women that were receptive on the planet to take more power and start to take control. This way they could guide them into more difficult learning experiences without having to introduce it themselves. The balance between male and female changed very fast, and control and abuse of power came in its place. The female part of the council was working against this, but there was no returning back from this, so it was decided they would take a step back and let the souls themselves find a way back to balance and being consciously open to higher dimensions. Some of the women incarnated on the planet many times to teach about how to balance the male and female and become fully conscious again. This had turned in completely new experiment, and after several council meetings and discussion with the souls that were incarnating on planet Earth, it was decided to play out this experiment this time. The experiment was stopped several times, as you might know from the stories about Lemuria and Atlantis. At this point, the Council of 24 became a complete and balanced unit again and used their own experiences to start guiding souls back to being a completely balanced spiritual being instead of just being a physical body. This is just a story to explain the basics of what happened on planet Earth. There was much more involved, but time and awakening more and more will bring you back the memories and knowledge that you have lost in the physical but are still there deep inside your soul.